Jamaica is too beautiful. Sometimes the beauty of it seems unreal. Sometimes the beauty of it seems as if it were stage sets for a play. For no real seawater could strike that many shades of blue at once. No real day could be that perfectly sunny and bright. And what might it do to ordinary people to live in this way every day? You taste a delicious Jamaican-grown banana for the very first time. You wonder how it is that you've never tasted such a sweet banana before.
Daylight come and me want go home. Work all night and I drink a rum.
Daylight come and me want go home.
Stack banana till the morning come.
Daylight come and me want go home.
Come Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and
Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me want go home.
A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana.
Daylight come and me want go home.
Hide the deadly black tarantula.
Daylight come and me want go home.
Live
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot punch.
Daylight come.
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot,
bunch. I actually was born in a banana farm for over the years, and I've been doing banana for all these years. Until lately, the WTO ruling has affected the industry.
I've been handling banana from in the early 60s, and recently, I'm not really exporting now because of the situation, the way they treat us.
We produce an export, and we would love to continue export to the fullest.
Jamaica produces at the moment in the region of 90,000 tons of bananas, all of which go into the UK, and that is our market.
Europeans who had colonies in the past thought it good, let us put it that way, that they should help these colonies to overcome some of their difficulties, to get them ready for new technology, to get them ready for the future. Under the Lome Agreement, this is an agreement between ACP countries, African, Caribbean and Pacific countries, with the European Union. The ACP countries enjoyed certain privileges because of their colonial past, and these countries in Europe feel that they should be able to give back something to the colonies in order to help them to take their rightful place in this world. As far as the banana trade is concerned, we have in Europe a guaranteed market, tariff-free.
The Americans, and to be brutally frank, I think it's Mr. Linda and his millionaires at Chiquita, are pressuring the ex-colonial countries through the WTO to get the WTO to agree that these preferential rates are unconstitutional and against the WTO regime.
The United States don't produce any bananas. Multinationals have set up their government to protest at the level of the WTO and affect the lives of a lot of people in the ACP countries.
On the worrisome banana issue and the recent World Trade Organization ruling, President Bill Clinton assured the Caribbean that his country did not act to the detriment of the Caribbean.
Pursuing and winning our case at the World Trade Organization, our target was a discriminatory European system, not the Caribbean nations. made it clear that as we work toward a solution with our European partners, we will continue to support duty-free access for Caribbean bananas in the European market, and we will seek ways to promote diversification of the Caribbean economies.
We have no access to the American market. The access we have is to Europe and to England in particular, and that is what Chiquita and the U.S. are trying to kill at this stage.
Big companies, which are American-owned, Chiquita, Dole, they already control 95% of the world market in bananas. But these companies want the whole hog.
Chiquita, Dole, Del Monte, all of this banana is being grown in Latin America. Life in Latin America is at the will of the master who owns these plantations.
Salaries for the workers are pitiably low. In one instance, I made to understand, so it's $1 per day. And nobody can exist on that sort of thing. Surely you will be able to produce cheaper bananas at that rate, but at what cost, socially and morally?
Por los efectos del humo de las bombas lacrimógenas, también comenzaron a ser capturados.
Some Chiquita banana workers went on strike. They were literally forced to go back to work with a gun. 23 people working. There are no unions.
Our bananas cost us more to produce than the South American bananas. It actually cost us $11 to produce 40 pounds of our bananas, while it cost them $5 to produce that set 40 pounds. We are unable to match the price of South Americans.
Well, in the past, things was very bright with us. But in the present right now, things low because the production gone down very low.
2 years ago, we had about 150 workers. Today, it's about 15 workers on the farm. My farm in particular, we have been trying to find investors to increase our capital over the last 2-3 years. But especially since the adverse WTO ruling, nobody will touch bananas. The banks won't invest in it. Private investors won't invest in it because the future looks dim.
The farmer here is, banana was on top. Banana was good. We could call it green gold in those days. Because a farmer could export his banana. He could have a nice dwelling. He could have a car. But no, you just can't. You're just living on survival now.
No all good. We can do, we can plant the banana because we love to plant, right? But we can't sustain our children without banana anymore. And that is the reason, one of the main reasons for the young man on the street now, looting and shooting, because the parents can't help him anymore. Guys, banana, just banana, we used to think of, send our children to school.
We would like to have some better things going for us here than for us to be cut out completely out of the market here in Jamaica.